Can you just show you about the today's class that is about the sorting algorithm, right? Okay, today I will teach you five kinds of sorting algorithms. We will start from insertion sort, bubble sort, selection sort, armor sort, and quick sort if it's possible to finish these two recursive algorithms for sorting algorithms. Okay, let me introduce you the easiest one, that is insertion sort. Okay, insertion sort is a very simple sorting algorithm, right? You can have a given array of integer or floating point, right? You can keep it into the list, and then you have to to sort in ascending order or descending order, it's up to you. Okay, and the technique of insertion sort is like what you are playing bitch or playing guard, right? You have to order a deck of cards, right? This is the main idea of the insertion sort, right? You have to insert each item into its proper place in the final list. Could you please think about playing cards? Right, when you play card, right, you have to sort in ascending order, right, while you are playing. And then once you get the new playing card, you have to sort it. You have to insert into the proper place, right? This is the way of the insertion sort does. Okay, to save memory, most implementation of insertion sort algorithm work by moving the current data element past the already sorted values. Repeatedly interchanging it with the preceding value until it's in the proper place. Okay, so anyway, this one is very simple and easy to understand, so it will be less efficient as compared to the other sorting algorithms like quick sort and heap sort, or even for the merge sort, right? Okay, so I will show you. Okay, this is what the insertion sort does, right? You have to, okay, if you have n minus one already sorted items, how to obtain the solution for problem size n? Okay, you have to press. Okay, let me show you the insertion sort in this example. For this example, we have the original problems like this. Like this one is a unsorted list, right, of the integers. Right, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 integers, right, unsorted. So what we have to do is, okay, we have to start from this list. So the algorithm is take the leftmost item as already sorted. Okay, as already sorted. So in this way we have 89, right? So we will set 89 as the leftmost sorted. Okay, so leftmost, the sorted list will be highlighted with the blue one. The blue highlight. Okay, and then we have to select the next one. That is a 45, right? What we have to do is, so let you think about this when you have this list, like, but you have to think of it as you get this one as the first playing card or the first item that you are going to sort. And then the first one is 89, right? And then the second one is once you get the 45, right, you have to put the 45 in the proper place, right? And then you can see that this one is sorted. And then once you get 68, right, you have to place 68 in between 45 and 89, okay? Then we have 90, okay, 90 is in the proper place already, so we will get this one. And then once 29 is here, so 29 will be moved to the first one, and then we have to shift the rest of this sorted to the right hand side. And then once we have the 34, right, where to put the 34, right, we have to put in the second place. We will do this repeatedly, right? Once you can, and the last one is 17. 17 is the minimum value, right? You have to put to the first place, and then you have to shift this back. So you can see that if you use these kinds of algorithm, right, it's very simple to understand, and it's very simple as well to write a program. But you can see that if once you you have the new one, and the new one is has to be in the first place or in between, you have to shift the list of array, right, to the right. You have to shift this, right? You can see this. You have to shift this to the right, one step. So you have to, how many moves do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? This is about, almost about the whole elements in this array. So you have to keep in mind that this one will be less efficient. So how can we do that? But okay, in the first place, you may have to understand about this algorithm, the simplest one, right? For the sorting algorithm, right? Because this one is new to you, right? So, what I have to put in this place. Okay, so this is an insertion sort algorithm, right? So the leftmost one is in the term of the pseudo code, right? First, we have to repeat the step from 1 to n minus 1, right? Have to set temp with the array k, right? Array k is 1, right? So let me explain you this algorithm by using the C programming. Okay, so we have to we have three variables, right? I, j, and temp, right? But you have to use I and j because we are going to have two loops, right? The first loop will be the outer loop, that is I from 1 to n minus 1. And then you have to keep the first one, the first element in array, right, to the temp, right? And then you set j to I minus 1, right? Why? What does it mean by this while loop? Why temp is less than arrj? What does this mean? Now, temp is the current position, right? I, right? And j is I minus 1. So you have to check for the rest, okay? This is I, this is, for the first loop, right, I is 1, right? So we will not have the, okay, because we have 0, right? This is 1. This is 1, this is 0, right? When I is equal to 1, right? So we have to check between this, right? This is I, this is j, right? If array I is less than j, if array I is less than array j, right? because it's the temp, right? Array I is kept to the temp, and then j is still greater than or equal to zero, then you have to array j plus one. You swap array j and array j plus one. Why? This one is I, this one is j, right? J and j plus one. Okay, because 45 is less than 89, right? So you have to swap this one with this one. This one, this is one. So we get 45 here. Okay. And then j minus minus. Okay, we will keep doing this loop until j temp is greater than or equal to array j, right? But in this way, in this example where we have to stop and then we put temp to the place of j plus one. What is j plus one? Temp will be I, right? And j plus one will be here. So we'll put 45 to this place. Okay, so what does this mean? It means it like this, okay? When you start for to consider this one, you have to check until you find the proper place for 45, right? Have to check for this. If 45 is less than 89, so you have to swap or you have to change 89 to this place and then check for it, right? But this one, like we go to the last index zero. So 45 is here. So once we have to check for the new one, the 68, right? You have to check 68 is less than this. So you have to swap this 89 to this place and then continue checking with the next one, right? But 68 is greater than 45. So we have to stop here and then press 69, which is in the temp, right, into this array. Okay, and then we stop. So for 29 as well, right? 29, you check this one, 90 is greater than, so copy 90 to this. Check with 89, copy 89 to this. Checking with 68, right? You copy 68 to this place, and then check with 45, still less than, right? So copy to this. And then when you come up with to the last place, right? That is I is equal to zero. This one is I equal to zero, then you place 29 to this place. This is a proper place. Okay. So you have to, okay, if j is still greater than or equal to zero, then you keep doing this loop, right? Keep decrement the variable j minus minus. And then you have to keep to place the temporary variable in this variable temp, right, to the place that array j plus one. Okay, this is what we do for the insertion sort. So if I ask you about why this one is not appropriate for being your sorting algorithm. Because if you have to find the place, let's say this example, 17, right? You have, how many swap do you have? How many copy do you have? You have copy one time, two time, three, four, five, and six, right? So you have to shift all numbers to the right. Okay, and then you have to put this one to the correct place. This is not efficient, but this one is easy to implement. Let's see this. Okay, what we will put to here? Anyone can help me to what is the instruction in line 8? What is the A? A J plus one, right? A J. Okay, am I right? Okay, do you have any questions? And if we want to find the complexity or the effectiveness of this algorithm, you have to count the number of comparisons or the compare or the number of the assignment, right? Or the number of the loop. Do you remember how to find the complexity of this algorithm? You have to know the number of the loops, right? Or the order of the for loop. So this way you may have to, for the worst case, right, you have to find the number of loop, right? It's very easy, right? Because for the outer loop, right, you have to, okay, sigma I from 2 to n, right? From 2 to n. And then inner loop. What is the number of inner loop? From j is greater than 1 to aj is still greater than v, right? So j will be decrement, right, until j will be from 1 to I minus 1, right? I minus 1, because for each loop, right, you have to set up new j, right? That is I minus 1. And you have to count until j is still, this loop will do until j is less than 1, right? Or equal to 1, right? So, and we have 1 and 2 statements, so you have 2. This is a count, the number of assignment statement here. This one is assignment statement. Count the number of assignment statements. Okay, so you have to find this value. This one is 2, right? 2 will be moved from this to outer loop. And then what is this? Sigma j from 1 to I minus 1, right? And this one is 1. So it will be I j from 1 to I minus 1, so it's I minus 1. Okay, this one is I minus 1. Actually, it's multiplied by 2, and then we move 2 outside this loop. So we can get this. And then I from 2 to n, but I minus 1 will be from 1 to n minus 1. So this will be 1 to n minus 1. Right, and then summation of I from 1 to n is equal to n multiplied by n plus 1 divided by 2, right? But this one is n minus 1 to n minus 1, so we have n and n minus 1. And then you multiply by 2 here, so you can get rid of 2 here. So you can have n multiplied by n minus 1. And then n multiplied by n minus 1 is equal to n squared minus n. So it is a big O n squared. O n squared. So this is the complexity of the insertion sort that is a quadratic complexity. Quadratic complexity is n raised to the power 2. Big O n raised to the power 2. Okay, so that's why insertion sort is not efficient, because you have still the number of the loop that you have to perform is still n raised to the power 2 n squared. Why is not efficient? Because if you have just only 10 elements in your list, it's okay. 10 multiplied by 10. 10 squared, right? So if you go to 100, that's okay. But if you have, let's say, 1 meg, okay, 1k, right? 1,000 raised to the power 2 is equal to 1 meg, right? It's very huge. So it's not okay for sorting. You have this waste of time. So you may have to find other algorithms that are more efficient than this. Okay, so first of all, you have to try to understand about the simplest one first. This one is the insertion sort, and it's not okay. So we have to, before we go to the next sort, that is a bubble sort, right? We have to check for the, okay, advantages of the insertion sort. The first one is it is easy to implement and efficient to use for the small set of data. Okay, it can be efficiently implemented on the data set that's already sorted. If your list is sorted, has been sorted already, so it will be efficient because you don't have to move to anything. But if it is sorted already, so you don't have to copy or shift the list. It perform better than algorithm like selection sort and bubble sort. Okay, we have to check for this later. Insertion sort algorithm is simpler than shell sort. You also have the shell sort and made trade off in efficiency. It is over twice as fast as the bubble sort. Okay. And it requires less memory space, so you don't have to allocate the extra memory space. Okay, and it is said to be online, as it can sort a list as and when it receives new elements. Mm-hmm. It's online. Okay. These are the advantages of insertion sort. Okay, but insertion sort seems to be better than bubble sort and selection sort. And we are going to talk about the next one, that is a bubble sort. Bubble sort is also a simple method to, that you can use to sort element, array element, okay, by repeatedly moving the large element to the highest index position of the array element. Okay, it's like when you have the bubble, right? And bubble will always, okay, from below, like when you have the bubble, and bubble will float up, right? So this is the same thing, right? Like the name, right? The largest element be bubble will be float, right, to its correct position. In bubble sorting, the consecutive adjacent pairs of element will be swapped, will be compared. If they are not in the proper position, they will swap. Okay, they will swap the element. If the element at the lower index is greater than the element at the higher index, two elements will be swapped, will be interchanged, or will be swapped. So that the element is placed before the bigger one, okay, in the proper place. This process will continue until the list of unsorted element sorts are sorted. Okay, this is a bubble sort. Okay, let's see this one. Okay, suppose we have the same example, right? We have to sort this list, right? As I just told you, right, when you see this one is 89, right? 89 is greater than this 45, so you have to swap this one. And then 89, 69, okay, 89 is greater than, so swap. 89 and 90, no, you don't have to stop, right? But 90, greater than 29, so swap these two. And 90 is here. And then 90 swap with 34, so 90 will be here, 34 will be here. And then 90 and 17, right, swap. So the highest element will be placed to the top, okay? It's like a bubble, right? So in this way, for the first pass, right, you can see that this one will be the highest element, and this one will be sorted, so we place the vertical bar here to show that this one is sorted, okay? Similarly, right, you have 45 and then swap. Do you have to swap with 69, 68? No. Right, at 68, no. And 89, okay, swap. 89 to this, 89 to this, okay? And we have to sort until 17, right? So the number of elements to be sorted will be reduced by one, right? Because we have known in advance that this one is sorted. And then we have the 89 that is sorted as well. So it's here, okay? And then you can keep doing this until the array is sorted, okay? So this is an algorithm of bubble sort. So bubble sort is very simple, right? So you have to start from, okay, I from 0 to n, n minus 1, and j from 0 to n minus I minus 1. What does it mean by n minus 1, n minus I minus 1? So you have to keep doing this until the unsorted place. As I just told you, right, when you sort this one already, and 90 will be in the proper place. So you don't have to go until the last element or the last index of this array. You have to go to until n minus 1, n minus 1, and minus I as well. So that's why this loop will be until n minus 1 minus I, or n minus I minus 1, right? And then you have to compare aj and aj plus 1, right? The consecutive element, right? The consecutive element, right? And then if j is greater than j minus 1, if j element array j is greater than j plus 1, so you have to swap. This is the swap function, right? What you have to do is, okay, flag is equal to 1, so it means that it has not yet, we are going to swap this. And in order to perform the swap, right, you have to set up the temp variable, right, by array j plus 1 plus 2 temp, and array j will press to j plus 1, and array temp will be assigned to array j. Okay, this is the way that we use for swap two elements. Okay, you have to you keep doing this until the flag is equal to 0. Okay, if the flag still, okay, so the flag is equal to 1, it means that there is a swap. Right, there are some swap, right? So, but if this array has been sorted, the flag will be 0, because for the initialization place, right, flag will be set up to 0 first. If you come up with the flag is equal to 0, right? For the inner loop, right? The inner loop will check just for checking if there is at least one swap, the flag will be set to 1. Oh, I see. This one will be, this line is added, because if you found that for the inner loop, right, there is no swap. So it means that this array has been sorted already. So for the first pass, right, for the first loop, I is equal to 0 if there is no change here. So it means that array is sorted. So you have to return, or we have to stop this function and then go back to the main function that is the caller of this function. Okay, so this way is to make this algorithm efficient. Mm-hmm. So let's come to this one, to what will be placed here. What should be placed here? Anyone can help me to answer this question? Hello, anyone here? This one will be swap. Swap A J plus 1 and A J. You have to swap these two elements, right? Because if A J plus 1, this is on the right, and this one is A J is on the left. If this one is less than, okay, so you have to swap these two array, okay? This is a bubble sort, but the bubble sort, right, you have known in advance that for the swap function or the swap element, you need 3 three statements. Okay, we need two statements because if you want to swap A and B, right, you have to move A to term first, and then you have to copy B to A, and then for B, right, we have to copy term that is A to B. So this is a four statement for swapping two elements in array. Okay, so the next one, the next step is you have to find the complexity. Okay, you have to find, in order to find the complexity, you have to count the number of comparison here. This one, C is comparison. You have to count for the number of comparison. Right, this is the complexity of this. Okay, so it's pretty easy, right? Because I from 1 to n minus 1. I from 1 to minus, n minus 1, and J from 1 to n minus I, J from 1 to n minus I, and this one we have just only one in the inner loop, right? We have just only one comparison, so we put one here. Okay, so, and this one, J from 1 to n minus 1, right? And this is a constant 1, so n minus 1 will be here. And then this remain the same. And then you can get this one. Okay, J from 1 to n minus I, so n minus I. And then I from 1 to n minus 1. So you have to split this one into two terms, right? The first term is n, the second term is I, okay? I from 1 to n minus 1, but multiply by n. So it will be like n. This one is n multiplied by n minus 1, right? For each loop, you will do n times, and then we have n minus 1 loop. So it will be n multiplied by n minus 1. This one is n minus 1. And this one is n minus 1 divided by 2. When you use minus, so you can have n multiplied by n minus 1 divided by 2. And then it's the same as the previous algorithm that is an insertion sort. So the complexity is big O n squared. Big O n squared. So in the examination, if I ask you to prove for the number of comparison or the complexity of bubble sort, you have to prove like this, okay? Until you get the big O n squared. Can you do that? Okay, I hope you can do that. Okay, this is a bubble sort. So you can see that for the complexity, when you compare bubble sort and insertion sort, they are similar, right? Because of n squared. But if you concern it into detail, right? It's the same, right? They are the same, n multiplied by n minus 1 divided by 2. And how about insertion sort? Insertion sort is, there is no divided by 2, but okay, n minus 1. For insertion sort, n minus 1. But for the bubble sort, n multiplied by n minus 1 divided by 2. Which one is better? It seems like this one is better, right? But you have to remember that this one you have to multiply by three statements for each loop. Okay, so it might be T over 2, right, n minus 1, okay? This is why bubble sort is less efficient than the insertion sort, right, in this way, right? Because we have, okay, maybe we think about the swap, this is only one statement, but inside this one statement, we have three statements inside. Okay, you have to keep in mind and you have to be careful about this. Okay, when you compare between insertion sort and bubble sort. The complexity of any algorithm depends upon the number of comparison. In bubble sort, right, there are n minus one pass in total in the first pass, and then n minus one comparison are made to place the highest element into its correct position. Then in pass two, there are n minus one comparison, right, and the second highest element replaced to the position. So we will have n minus one plus n minus two plus one plus n minus three and so on until one, right? And then when you transform this into a formula, you can get this formula n minus one divided by two. And then you can get this one and then big O n squared. Okay, so this one is a complexity. So the complexity of bubble sort algorithm is big O n squared. It means that the time required to execute bubble sort is proportional to n squared, okay? Where n is the total number of elements in the array, okay? We have already talked about this already, okay? This is a bubble sort. Bubble sort is very easy to understand because you can just simply pick up, try to scan which one is the highest value, right? And then for the first path, you have to put the highest value into the rightmost array, right? And then for the second highest most, you have to put in front of the highest one, right? And so on, right? So this one is pretty easy to understand, and also it is easy for writing a program as well. So here we come to the third one, that is a selection sort. Selection sort is a sorting algorithm, right? It has quadratic learning time, right? As same as bubble sort and insertion sort, the big O n squared. Thereby making it inefficient to be used on large lists. It's not efficient. Although selection sort perform worse than insertion sort. So this one is worse comparing to the insertion sort and bubble sort, right? It can be noted that its simplicity and has performance advantages over more complicated algorithm in certain situation. We use selection sort in general it's generally used for sorting files with large objects or large record and small keys. Okay, you have the spatial application of selection sort. So come to check for the selection sort. So the same example, right? The first step is divide the list into the sorted one, right? There's no one, right? Sorted one, there is no, for the initialization, there is no sorted, right? Sorted list, and this one will be the unsorted list. Then we have to scan the unsorted list for the smallest element. Now, smallest element. For the bubble sort, right, you have to keep tab on the highest element. If it is the highest element, it will swap with its consecutive element until it will go to the proper place. For the selection sort, right, you have to find the smallest one, right? And then once you find the smallest one here, you have to move to the sorted list. And then this one will be okay. This one will be sorted. This one unsorted. And then for the second pass, well, you have to find the lowest one among this list, we get 29. So 29, we move to this, and then sorted list will come to here. This is a vertical bar. This, you cannot see this in the program, but this will be in your imagination that we have to separate these two sets, two lists in array. Okay, you have to keep track on trying to find the minimum value or the smallest element. Now, 24, we move to here, and then 45 here, 68 and 68 here, and then 89 here. So this one is a selection sort. Selection sort means select the smallest one and move it to the proper place into the sorted list. Sorted list, and here we are. Yes. More or less, selection sort is similar to bubble sort, right? But in different way, in opposite way. For bubble sort, the highest value will move from left to right. But for the selection sort, the smallest value will move from right to left. But for the bubble sort, you have to compare between two consecutive elements. But for selection sort, right, you have to keep track on finding the smallest element in the unsorted list or the right list. Okay, these are the differences between the selection sort and bubble sort. But you can see that, okay, this one is 89, right? And we have to keep going on to find the minimum one, right? When you find the minimum one, you have to swap this element. Okay, now you can see 17 here and 89 here. In the place of 89 is supposed to be 11, and in the place, so 11 will be moved to here, swap or assigned to this position, and we have to assign this value into the position of 17 as well. So it means that we have to swap these two elements. Okay, for 29 as well, we have to swap with this one, 45 and 29. So one pass, right? In one pass, you will have just only one swap. Do you get the point? For bubble sort, you have to swap anytime that the right value is less than the left value, then you will swap. So you have to swap many times as long as the condition met. But in this way, selection sort, just only one swap per one pass. Just only one swap, okay? So it seems to be better than bubble sort, okay? So for selection sort, right, if ij is less than a min, A min is a position that is going to be swapped for each time, right? And AJ will be the minimum value. Okay, if you keep track on finding the minimum value, right? If AJ is less than A min, previous min, so we have to press J to min. And then after you finish the first part, you have to swap the element in index I with the element in index min. You have to know in advance that min will be the minimum value, right? Mm-hmm. So there will be one swap only. So if you want to find the complexity of selection sort, right, you have to, okay, this one is outer loop is 1 to n minus 1, 1 to n minus 1. And inner loop, j from I plus 1, j from I plus 1 to n. Okay, and you have just only one comparison here. So this is one. So j from I plus 1 to n. So, and each loop will be one. So it will be from n minus I. Because this is from I plus 1 and then I plus 2, I plus 3, and so on to n, right? So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, right? This number of I, this is I, n minus I, right? And then this one, this loop, I form 1 to n minus 1. So you have to split into two terms, right? And then you have the first term is n minus 1. Second term is n minus 1 divided by 2, okay? Similar to the bubble sort, and then you can get this one. And then big O is n squared. Once again, we have the swap function, right? There are three statements for swap function, but you can do this one time per one loop or one pass. So that's all. This is the advantage of using the selection sort. I think selection sort is quite interesting, okay? And you just swap only the index. You keep track on the index. Okay, can we find the, okay, where is the selection sort program? Okay, this is a selection sort. Okay, this is a complexity, how to find the complexity of selection sort, right? I have already told you, okay? And advantages of using selection sort, the first one is it is simple and easy to implement, that's right. Second, it can be used for a small data set, okay? If you have the huge data set, it's not okay. So you have to use other kinds of sorting algorithm, and it is 60% more efficient than bubble sort. Because why? Because bubble sort, you have to swap all the time. But for selection sort, you have to swap only one time per one pass. So that's why it is about 60% more efficient. However, in case of large data set, the efficiency of selection sort drops as compared to the insertion sort. Right? If the data set is high, right, you have to, okay, to it's better to use the insertion sort. Okay, you have to remember which one is the case that is appropriate for each sort. Okay, this one is selection sort. Okay, I think I will stop here for the sort, and when we come back from Songkran festival, so it means that 2 weeks after this week, so we have to start talking about the sort and quick sort, right? Because if I teach you now, you will forget for sure. So I think I will stop here, and then we have 1 hour left for checking that you understand about the selection sort. So I will let you try to implement these three sorting algorithms, right? During this hour, right? When you have 1 hour, you can implement these three sorting algorithm, right? If it's possible, I would like you to maybe to use Mathematica in order to write the program to prove to sort this one, because I have already given you the bubble sort, insertion sort, and insertion sort in C programming. So I would like you to try to practice about writing Mathematica program, right? So I have 1 hour for you all to try to implement these three sorting algorithms. And then if you finish this, you can go. Okay. So let